Hi, my name is Louis. Boolean operations are a fantastic way to quickly cut and join objects with other objects in Blender, particularly for creating, robots? Like we do in our new Robotic Planet course for Blender. However, they don't always work, and it can be frustrating to work out why. So for this video, we're going to go through 7 common Boolean issues and how to solve them. We'll also be using the Bool tool, a native Blender add-on that can be activated from the preferences here. Okay, let's start by brushing up on the different type of Booleans. Difference. The cutter mesh is subtracted from the modified mesh. Union. The cutter mesh is added to the modified mesh, removing any interior faces. Intersect. Everything inside both the cutter mesh and the modified mesh is kept. Slice. This is an additional option available through the native Bool tool add-on, and it has the same effect as duplicating the modified mesh, running intersect on one and then difference on the other. Sometimes Boolean operations can result in mesh artifacts, and a lot of these cases can be solved by simply switching the solve method from exact to fast or vice versa. If this doesn't work, there may be larger mesh problems at play that we need to diagnose, so let's look at a few common issues. Okay, first up we have overlapping geometry, like in this example, so let's do a Boolean operation with our cutter selected and then our modified mesh, and let's use difference. And everything has disappeared, this is less than ideal, so let's do our quick fix by switching the solver. It's better, but it's not brilliant. So what's going on? Let's select our cutter and jump into edit mode here. And if we just hit L on the keyboard to select one of the cutters, we can move it, and you can see that if there isn't any overlap, the cut happens just fine. But what if we do want to have this shape? Well, then we have to do 2 Boolean cuts. So with our second mesh selected here, let's hit P. Separate by selection and do a second Boolean. So cutter, modified, control shift B, and difference. And then we have the result that we want. Moving on. Okay, normals. This looks relatively harmless at first. So let's select our cutter and our modified, control shift B, and then difference. Okay, that's not really worked in our favor. Well, this is quite difficult to see unless we go up to viewport overlays and check face orientation. Now we can see that the normals of some of our mesh here is flipped. So we can select our modified, go into edit mode, select all, and then we can just hit shift and N to recalculate outside. And let's jump back out into object mode, and our cut has worked just fine. Okay, time for our watertight example. So again, cutter and then the modified, control shift B, and difference. Now, this doesn't look like a difference to me, and switching solvers doesn't do anything. So what's the issue? The issue is that our cube mesh here is non-manifold geometry. Non-manifold geometry is any geometry that doesn't exist in the real world. Things like an edge without polygons either side, or an impossibly flat plane, or a hole in our geometry making the walls impossibly thin, hence the phrase watertight. Again, these can be tricky to diagnose as the holes can be very, very, very small. A quick way to solve this is to add in a weld modifier. So if we add modifier, select weld, and move it above our Boolean operation, and start increasing the distance. Now this automatically merges vertices that are very, very close together, closing any holes in our geometry in the process. However, if this still doesn't fix things for you, let's just remove that. We can jump in to edit mode, and as long as we are on vertex selection here, we can go up to select, select all by trait, and then non-manifold. And here we have highlighted the issue. Let's just look here, and we can see that this is a hole. So if we just zoom back out, and I'm just going to affect our modifier in edit mode here, and then I'm just going to hit F to fill the hole, and our Boolean operation works perfectly. Okay, object scaling issues. Let's do our Boolean operation again. Difference. And we can see that we have a little bit of an issue here. And you'll also note that with our cube selected and looking at our transforms, we have lots of different values here, particularly our scale, which is very much not uniform. Thankfully, we can fix all of this with our box selected, hitting Control and A, and then just applying all transforms. And that fixes up our Boolean cut nicely. Right, let's look at the zero area face issue that you might come up against. Let's do our Boolean operation, difference. And here on fast mode, we have a bit of an issue here, which we can diagnose further by switching on wireframe. And as you can see in our cube geometry here, we just select an edge, we have some hidden polygons, making the area of said polygons zero. Now we can just add a world modifier like we did before. However, if you want to do it in the mesh level, I'm just going to switch on edit mode for our Boolean here. We can jump into edit mode, select all, hit M on the keyboard and merge by distance. And lo and behold, our Boolean operation is working. Okay, let's look at the self-intersecting issue. So again, let's do our Boolean operation. Control-Shift-B, difference. And again, we have this kind of result. And this is due to our cube mesh here self-intersecting. So if, for example, we were to go into wireframe and just move this out, making sure we are on edit mode for our Boolean operation, you can see that it pops into life here. So to keep the same look, we can either make sure that we don't intersect at all, or you can take advantage of the exact solver settings here. If we drop down, we can check self-intersection, and that brings our Boolean back to life. Okay, let's look at our first mirror issue here, and I have already done our Boolean operation here. So if we hide our cutter, you can see that it's not quite doing the shape that we want. And this is because we have our mirror modifier after our Boolean operation. So if we move that above, problem solved. That's a nice quick one. But let's say we have applied our mirror modifier. If we do our Boolean operation here, it's nearly working, but not quite. And this is because we have some geometry inside our cube volume. Thankfully, in order to solve this, we can jump into edit mode, go up to select, select all by trait, interior faces. And this just selects those interior faces. So let's hit X on the keyboard and delete faces. And our Boolean comes back to life. It's worth noting that we have been fixing the modified mesh, but these issues can also be applied to the cutter mesh. So if you're still having problems, it might be worth checking there too. I hope this video helps you with making whatever it is you're making. And if you're not sure what to make and you want to flex your Boolean muscles, you might be interested in our new Robotic Planet course, where we'll cover even more complex Boolean operations as well as mesh cleanup, among many other things. Check the link out in the description for more information. I hope to see you there.